Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel, and today I'm back with another Dying Light 2 video. Now, as we all know, Dying Light 2 is releasing on December 7, 2021. So before that, I wanted to make a video that will have basically all the info that everyone needs to know before Dying Light 2 is released. So let's get started. Aiden Caldwell is the main protagonist of Dying Light 2 Stay Human. Aiden is a member of Pilgrims, a loose gathering of post-apocalyptic drifters wandering the ruins of the old world. Aiden arrives in the city, the nameless metropolis where the game is set. Aiden is looking for his sister, Mia. Aiden is plagued by vague, disconnected memories of her when he learns the people responsible for what happened to her have been found there in the city. He embarks on a mission to learn the truth. Interestingly, the city is in a totally fixed, static environment. Parts of it can change based on the many decisions you make over the course of the game. Meaningful player choice is something the developer is striving for, including making you feel bad as the consequences of your actions play out in front of you. As you progress through the story, you will affect the lives of people in small, individual ways, but also change the layout of the city itself. Your decisions can shape the appearance of locations and affect the factions living in the city. And you will see the outcome of this impact on the environment. That increases the replayability of the game, and it's worth going through the game more than once or in the co-op to discover everything that is impacted by these choices. There are interesting side quests that will also have their own consequences. Some choices you may even regret when your actions makes the lives of other residents of the city difficult. Dying Light 2 has three main factions. First faction is the Peacekeeper, and they are dedicated to eliminating all threats to humanity in the world. They want to rally citizens to their views and secure territory for a new society based on their principles. They got some serious rules. The second faction is Survivors. The Survivors believe that their survival depends on their ability to foster craftsmanship and relearn ancient skills to thrive. They value experimentation, art, culture, and knowledge, and passing this down to their children. Now, the final faction is called Renegades. Renegades believe in the sacrifice for the greater good. They are ruthless, militarized criminal organization, resorting to immoral means to ensure their survival. Now, when you play Dying Light 2, you will be able to work for these three factions, but working for one that is the enemy of another won't go unnoticed. There's also a new system called City Alignment, where you can assign specific zones of the city to one of the factions, which of course may also influence the world and the story in interesting ways. When night falls, the streets are overrun with infected. The safe option is to stay on the rooftops and wait for the sun to send them scurrying back in their lairs. But if you're feeling brave, venturing down into the depths of the city can net you some good quality loot. Building interiors that are usually teeming with zombies are suddenly empty, with only a few stragglers remaining, letting you sneak in to grab gears and upgrades. After that, you just have to worry about making it out and back to the relative safety of the rooftops. The city transforms at night. Citizens hide away in their hiding places, the glow of the UV lamp is visible everywhere, and the silence of the night is interrupted by the sound of monsters crawling out in the streets. A world full of dangers by the day becomes a whole different challenge at night. The layers of the infected become empty, giving you the opportunity to explore and find useful and sometimes very valuable items. While the most zombie games are set in the immediate aftermath of an outbreak or long after it, this story takes place just as the world has gotten over the initial shock and is starting to rebuild. 15 years have passed since the global apocalypse that followed the virus emerging, and Techland has tried to make the city reflect this in a realistic and credible way. Modern Dark Ages is a civilization that returned to medieval times in the modern day with the memory of the world before the fall. So basically, it's the modern day, but everything has gone back to the medieval times. The resources are very rare, so you're gonna see a lot of items from the medieval times. Dying Light 2 has a huge list of returning monsters, and 15 years of mutation has brought some new and deadlier version of the infected. Some monsters we are aware of are Demolisher, Viral, Biter, Volatile, Drowner, Revenant, Banshee, Bomber, Goon, Howler, Hazmat, Snatcher. And that's not it. There are more monsters that we don't know about yet, because there are many monsters that will only be available if you make a certain choice. Now, I have made separate videos for each and every monster, so you can check my playlist. The link will be in the description. You will need to master Adrian's parkour skills to outsmart Dying Light 2's wider range of zombies. This time, Dying Light 2 has doubled the parkour moves, and getting around the city is made easier by the fact that Adrian is a skilled free runner. The parkour system in Dying Light 2 is much more complex and natural feeling than in the previous game, and you will also have access to way more moves. Parkour is the essence of Dying Light 2. Dying Light 2 has crazy parkour combinations that allow you to do really wild acrobatics and tools that allow you to diversify limited human movements with new possibilities. In addition, there's a refreshed grappling hook and a paraglider system which increases the importance of gravity and natural movement in the game. But as we know, the player's main way of moving around the city would be on foot. And the best part is that the map is 2 times the size of the original 2 maps combined. Well, in an apocalypse, society becomes brutal and all its elements are re-evaluated. The title Stay Human covers 2 issues, physical and mental. On the physical side, this is of course avoiding transformation due to infection, controlling the disease through biomarkers, and taking care of exposure to UV lights. In short, stay human as a living being and prevent yourself from turning into a monster. The second layer, humanity, is about remaining human according to the norms and principles we know. The world after the apocalypse has changed in almost every respect, and it will be up to the player whether they will be guided by the goods of the individual, the greater good, or maybe take a different path altogether. You can decide what path you will take when Dying Light 2 Stay Human is released on December 7, 2021 on all platforms. Thank you for watching, stay safe, and stay human.